Okay, today we are going to make babka. We're going to flour our surface. And we're going to take our dough, which we prepared earlier. And we're going to begin rolling it out. It's a nice dough. It's not very sticky, so it works really well and rolls out really, really well. We want to make it as thin as we can and as large as we can. So we have a lot of filling to put in it. Okay, we're just going to keep rolling it until it's about an eighth to a 16th of an inch thick. Now we have our filling, which I prepared. This is very, very rich and chocolatey. And the recipe allows for quite a lot of it on the dough at a time. Since I divided everything into four, I need to divide the filling into four. So this is a quarter of the batch. We're going to spread it out to within an inch of the edge of the dough. Kind of get it as even as you can. This filling has sugar, cocoa, chocolate pudding mix, margarine, and hot water and eggs. So it's an interesting filling that I have not tried before, but I was told it is very, very delicious, and I'm looking forward to trying it. There are no nuts in this recipe, so that's always good. Okay, so this is basically nice and even. And now we are going to roll it. Just start to pick it up, roll. This is a little bit square. More than a rectangle, it would probably have been better to make it a little bit longer on one side, a little more of a rectangle shape. This came out to a nice long log. I take my knife and I'm going to cut the log in half. Now here's where it gets messy, but it's worth it. Come in close and see how it looks. Here's your filling. Now because the filling is it is moist, but it's not runny, so it won't really go anywhere. It will get a little bit onto your counter, and you will have to clean up in between each batch, but it doesn't run, which is nice. So we kind of mush the top together, and then grab the ends, oops, and just start to go like this. And just go around and around. Simple, it's going to get a little messy, doesn't matter. And then fold the whole thing in half and put it into your well-greased and very lightly floured pan. And then we're going to do the top. Okay, now we're going to make the crumble topping for the babka, which consists of one stick of margarine and a cup of flour. So I'm just going to put in part of it and start to mix up the margarine. Okay, I'm going to add some more and 3/4 of a cup of white sugar. And that's all it is, very simple. Just need to get all these ingredients well mixed. It's going to be a little bit crumbly, as it should be. At some point, you can kind of do a lot of this with your hands. A couple of pieces of sugar in there. All right. and just get it to the point where it resembles crumbs and the margarine is well mixed. And again, this becomes a pretty generous amount, so we're going to be able to be pretty generous with the crumbs on top of the babka. We're just going to sprinkle it all over. And of course, this margarine will melt and make it nice. For 40 minutes, coming out nice and golden. Looking good. We'll try some soon. Stay out of that babka. Hey! Okay, these are still a little warm, but it's time to take them out of the pan so they can cool off and not steam in the pan. So we've got it coming out right now. And while it's still warm, I think we will give our fabulous onlookers a taste. Look at that. Now, would you like a taste, young master? Make a bracha. How is it?
Good.
Delicious?
Yes. Very good.
We have another taste tester over here, young Yaakov.
Quite edible. Delicious.